long. Over the past 2 years, they've been confronted by a series of really difficult decisions. These companies don't want to be in the business of making editorial judgments or content moderation judgments. They desperately do not want to be in that business. That's an expensive and hard business to be in. However, they've been given no choice because of the use of their platforms, the abuse of their platforms to incite violence. This is the first time a world leader has been removed from Twitter in this way. Think about that. It wasn't a dictator in some far off land. It was the United States president that was removed. Twitter's been under tremendous pressure from its own staff to take this step. Mm. And frankly, Fred, it's a lot easier to do it in the final few days of the Trump administration than it would have been to do this a year or two ago. Mm. So Twitter is receiving some credit, also a lot of blame for not doing this sooner, and also a lot of blame from Trump supporters who are going to feel even more aggrieved, even more isolated. Mm-hmm. Donald Trump Jr. this morning telling his fans to sign up for his own email server, his own email list, so he can stay in touch with them. And that reminds me of one other important detail. The Trump campaign is not sending out emails anymore. They're not even sending out emails anymore. So I'm starting to wonder if they're having a hard time getting access to servers to even send emails. This president is incredibly isolated right now. His platforms are shrinking by the hour. Maybe the only way he could reach the public right now is through an old-fashioned press.